Hello, good morning. Today we can discuss some more NEET question. Six question: match the items given in column first with those in column second and select the correct option given below. Column 1, tricuspid wall, bicuspid wall, semilunar wall. Column 2, between left atrium and left ventricle, between right ventricle and pulmonary artery, between right atrium and right ventricle. We know that tricuspid wall is a wall between right atrium and right ventricle. Bicuspid wall is a wall between left atrium and left ventricle. Semilunar walls are the walls present base of pulmonary artery in aorta. Okay, so we can say answer. Which will be the answer? Answer 4. Tricuspid walls are atrioventricular wall present between right atrium and right ventricle. Tricuspid wall. Okay, tricuspid wall. Then bicuspid wall or AV wall present between left atrium and left ventricle. Here bicuspid wall or mitral wall. Semilunar walls are present at the opening of aortic and pulmonary artery. So pulmonary artery, base of pulmonary artery and aorta, that is semilunar wall. Is it? So option 4. Next question. Choose the correct pathway on the transmission of impulse in the heartbeat. AV node, SA node, bundle of his Purkinje fiber. SA node, AV node, bundle of his Purkinje fiber. SA node, bundle of his AV node, Purkinje fiber. AV node, bundle of his SA node, Purkinje fiber. So we know that nodal tissue in heart, that is heart, is myogenic. SA node, sinoatrial node, can start the action potential which causes the contraction of atrium. Is it? So we can see position of these SA node and AV node, that is here SA node, sinoatrial node. This is the atrium, this is ventricle, right atrium, left atrium. Is it? So anyway, sinoatrial node, upper right corner of right atrium. Then next AV node. AV node also right atrium, lower left corner near AV septum. Okay, atrioventricular node. SA node can create action potential which help to start the contraction of atrium. So we can say the correct pathway of transmission of impulse in the heartbeat is SA node, then AV node, atrioventricular node, AV node. Then from AV node, you know that bundle, branched bundle in ventricle musculature, that we can call it as bundle of His. Then this bundle of His has many fibrous structure, that is called as that we can say Purkinje fiber. Is it? So SA node, AV node, bundle of His, Purkinje fiber. This is the correct pathway. So next question. Next question is that which blood vessel carry blood from different part of your body to the heart? Capillaries, arteries, veins, all of these. We know that arteries lumen is thicker, veins lumen is less thick, or we can say is wider than arteries. Arteries carry blood away from heart. Vein carries blood from body part to heart. You know, vena cava. Is it? So we can say Answer: the vessel carry blood from different part of your body to the heart, that is vein. Then, okay, then the option is that we can say vein. Veins carry the deoxygenated blood from body part to heart, veins. Then, these have thin wall and walls to prevent backflow. The blood flow in low pressure in vein. Blood flow is low pressure. Arteries carry oxygenated blood from heart to body part with high pressure. Okay. But keep in mind that pulmonary artery which carry impure blood to lungs for oxygenation, pulmonary vein carries pure blood from lungs to heart. That is the exceptional case, keep in mind that. So anyway, veins carry the deoxygenated blood from body part to the heart. C option. Next question is that why first child of Rh positive husband and Rh negative wife does not have erythroblastosis fetalis? Due to absence of Rh antigen in mother blood. Okay, then due to the presence of Rh antibodies in the mother's blood. Due to the absence of Rh antibodies in mother's blood, both A and C. Actually, what is in the case of erythroblastosis fetalis? Erythroblastosis fetalis. That is nothing but, you know, a special case of Rh incompatibility has been observed between Rh negative blood of pregnant mother with Rh positive blood of fetus. During the delivery of the first child, there is a possibility of exposure of the maternal blood to small amount of Rh positive blood from fetus. In such case, the mother start preparing antibodies against Rh antigen in her blood. In the case of the subsequent pregnancy, the Rh antibody from the mother can leak to blood of fetus and destroy fetal RBC. This could be fatal to fetus or could cause severe anemia and jaundice to the fetus. This condition called erythroblastosis fetalis. Anyway, here shown that erythroblastosis fetalis, what is that condition? First pregnancy, mother is Rh negative and father most probably Rh positive. So first fetus, that is Rh positive fetus, okay, Rh antigen will be there in fetus. So what will happen is that during first delivery, little bit of blood may exposure to mother blood delivery time. Okay. So that's why between the pregnancies, that means between the second pregnancy and first delivery, what will happen is that anti-Rh antibodies will be formed in mother blood. Okay. First time anti-Rh antibodies will not be there. Is it? After delivery only it will form. Then second pregnancy, what will happen? This is the fetus, Rh positive fetus, and antibodies and anti-Rh antibody will be there in mother blood. So it will act, so it enter into fetal blood and cause a destruction of RBC. That is, this could be fatal to fetus or could cause severe anemia and jaundice to the fetus. This condition is called erythroblastosis fetalis. Clear? So we can say option C is the option. Why? Due to the absence of Rh antibodies. So Rh antibody will not be there. Second, after delivery only anti-Rh antibodies. Okay. Rh antibody will be there. So due to the absence of Rh antibodies in mother's blood. So option C, is it? We can say that due to the absence of, this is option, due to the absence of Rh antibodies in mother's blood. So next question, which of the following act as middleman of the body? Plasma, lymph, RBC, WBC. So middleman of the body, we can see the option lymph act as middleman of the body. Actually, as the blood passes through the capillaries in tissue, some water along with many small water soluble substances move out into the space between the cells of the tissue, leaving the larger proteins and most of the formed elements in the blood vessels. These fluid released out is called the interstitial fluid or tissue fluid. Is it? So what is the function of that lymph, which help exchange of nutrients, gases, etc. between the blood and the cell always occurs through this fluid. Is it? An elaborate network of vessels called lymphatic system collect this fluid and drain back it back to the major veins. Lymphatic vessels, capillaries, etc. we can see, tissue cells we can see. Okay, so actually this help for lymph is also an important carrier of for nutrients, hormones and fat are absorbed through lymph in the lacteals present in the intestinal villi. So anyway, we can say lymph acts as middleman of the body. Okay, next question is that SAN can generate impulses 70 to 75 minute inverse, 50 to 55, 100 to 150, 35 to 40. SAN, sinoatrial node. We know the position of this SAN node. Right atrium, upper corner of right atrium. Okay, sinoatrial node, SAN node. So we can say option ...70 to 75 minute inverse. Okay, so heart is auto excitable, myogenic, you know that. We know the position of SA node and AV node, etc. Actually, autorhythmicity of the heart is the ability to contract spontaneously. Mammalian heart is myogenic. It means heartbeats result from a wave of electrical potential called cardiac impulse arising from sinoatrial node, SA node, and spreading over cardiac chamber. SA node lies in the wall of right atrium near opening of superior vena cava and contract about 72 times per minute. Keep in mind this, all very important points. From SA node, cardiac impulse travel to atrioventricular node lies between right atrium and right ventricle, AV node. Okay. Then pass AV bundle. This is called as AV bundle, also called bundle of His, and it branches, reaches to Purkinje fibers in ventricle. Purkinje fibers, you see. Bundle of His provide the only route for the transmission of wave excitation from atria to ventricles. Purkinje fibers conduct the impulse 5 times more rapid than surrounding cells. It forms a pathway for conduction of impulse that ensure that the heart muscle contract in the most efficient manner. So keep in mind that autorhythmicity and we can say the rate 70 to 75 minute per inverse. Okay, so option You understood that? What is that? So 70 to 75. Okay. Thank you.